anyway, Bush, Cassie, yeah, we'll look into that a bit later.
Buscassier.
Yeah, take a dead goat from one side to the other there. Let's get a dead goat and play some Bukkake. Or whatever it's called. Wait, that's
Did you just say
no,
Bukkake?
No!
You just said Bukkake, I'm pretty sure.
Well, you just said that. I didn't say it.
You definitely did not say it.
Death is the last man standing, and you can talk now.
Well, it's a team kill. Allege is going to feel the accidental wrath of Hiko. Well, 16 HP.
I can't believe you just said that on stream.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
People don't know what that means.
Well, they're on the internet, Dan. It's not hard to find out.
Yeah. I think you're making a big deal over this, Chase, for no reason. Not really a big deal, is it? Everyone knows what it is. Let's be grown-ups here.
I didn't know what it was. I had to Google it. I was like, oh.
What, just now? That's your complete
lie. No, just not now.
Well, Death is on a lot of ping, but he's able to get a very nifty headshot there, very swift frag onto Hiko, but you can see that the time is being played here by the CTs. And the problem is for Death, he knows as soon as he tries to get at the player on the side that the guy from Vent is going to try to peek out and remove him from the round. But what is this? How does Death creep up on Hiko? What? How did that happen? How did they let this happen, James? This was not supposed to be like this. It was not supposed to be like this. It's like Death is the X Factor, James, of the game. He knows the score.
Too much Bukkake, Dan.
He knows the score.
What is it called again, Reese?
The Score Esports.
Bukkake, okay.
Bukkake. Is there a Bukkake? Do they have a Bukkake second on the Score Esports app, James?
I don't know that it's esports, Dan. Although maybe somebody should make like a Madden equivalent of it, but with a dead goat instead of a ball, Dan. And horses. Well, we've got Complexity somehow on the winning end of that pistol round, and now they have Death moving in with the MAC-10. So, not the start that Liquid wanted, and maybe not the one they deserve either.
No, absolutely not. A bomb will go down here for Complexity. They're definitely a shoo-in to take this round. I wonder where that phrase came from. They're a shoo-in. I'm not sure. But it looks like Complexity will slowly eliminate the remainder of the Team Liquid lineup that are hiding in all the nooks, cranny, crevices, and other words for the same thing.
Bukkake, literally, goat dragging in Persian, also known as Kokpar Kupkari and Ulak Tartish, is the Central Asian sport in which horse-mounted players attempt to drag a goat or calf carcass towards a goal. It is the national sport of Afghanistan, although it was banned under the Taliban regime. I would like to observe a game of Bukkake.
Well, okay, you have to wait, James, because currently we have a game of Counter-Strike to observe.
I suppose we do.
We have a good observer too, Sliggy. He's observing again. So he's been back for a couple of days.
Yeah.
He spent some time in Jamaica.
Yeah.
Now he's back.
He wanted to be amongst the brothers, Dan. That's what he said.
Is that what? Is that?
He wanted to be amongst the mandem.
Is that
with a can of Supermalt, Dan?
Is that verbatim? I think it sounds like what something he would say. So it's just 5 pistols here for Liquid, no Kevlars. It's a complete full save. It cannot be more economic than this, really. I'm afraid that failure is assured. Although I suppose their expectation, it's not really failure because their expectation is to lose the round.
Yeah.
Indeed, it is actually victory, success, James, because they're playing economically at the expense of everything else.
Well, it depends on what their goals were, Dan. If they had goals in which they weren't achieved, then it was a failure.
Exactly,
if their goals were to kill 2 people, Dan, they only killed one.
James,
in the next sense, they had failed.
Hiko's killed one of his teammates. He's got -1. He killed, obviously, I think it was a Liege on the pistol round. Somebody on the pistol round died by Hiko's hand. And he's yet to remedy this. He's still on -1 as a reminder.
I team killed Delpan on a pistol round once.
And?
I found it amusing.
Great.
He didn't. But I did.
He probably deserved it.
Probably did. Liquid with 3 people towards B. There's lots of aggression towards there as well. Only Android X is in that position. He takes a Leash down, but he'll get traded by Hiko. The problem is now, or the question is rather, what Complexity can do with this information. I don't know how many of those 3 players Android X saw, but Complexity should sense some weakness over towards the A site, and indeed they are going to execute onto it. We've got Molotovs flying all over the place. Some flashes coming in from the CT to slow down the push from the T's, but it is a retake situation here for Liquid.
Yeah, it is. a retake situation indeed. There's quite a lot of nades here. They've got a lot of time to work with. Pretty much everybody's already there, so we can expect that coordination. They don't have to scramble too heavily. But the problem is that there's four T's, and Whitmer's on the AWP. If he's anything like he was in the first map, I think there's going to be problems here. But hey, Sanx is going to be throwing in problems himself already. Whitmer hitting one shot there as well. One for one. Can he go two for two? No. But his teammates are good for it. So pretty simple round there from Complexity to just break Liquid's first buy. And Liquid's having some troubles here. But at least Hiko got himself off the negatives.
It's a great start for Complexity.
It is.
It's a good start then.
It is indeed.
You could also call it a great start. So Whitmer is going to be continuing on the AWP, although it's Def who has been racking in the kills. In fairness, Liquid have had some eco rounds, so, you know, can't really say who's doing the best just yet. Elige under the boost. We'll see if Hiko makes his way over there. It appears that a boost may be attempted by one of these CTs. Indeed, there is said boost. Elige going up. Up top. Maybe hiding for a while. Sanx is currently holding the angle. You can see he is making sure he is well covered. I like that. I respect it. It's good. So Complexity seem to be posturing for a bit of an A play here. We're looking for some harassment, but there is nobody to harass. They are fast on the people to harass. Although, that said, with the time they have taken, now Liquid are moving into position. Nitro and Kusa getting taken down so far, so good for the side. Whitmer's lost his AK though. Let's see if the CTs can pick it up. Sorry, he's lost his AWP. Elige has picked up the AWP. But where is he? Can he save it? He's on the site, I think, with the AWP. And Adren's taking down Death, which saves Elige. And now things are getting mad weird. Because it's 3 versus 2. The bomb's moving into the B bomb site though, so Surreal is here alone. The bomb is going to get planted. And Complexity should be good for the round, because in this situation, Elige is 7 HP, Adren with 9, and an AWP in tow. They really want to save this, although Surreal knows where the AWP is now. And, well, Adren can't save him anymore. And down goes Elige. We'll see if the AWP can be rescued by Surreal. I think it can. Yes, it will be. So Complexity rescue the round, and Liquid will be back on the buy. So good damage, all things considered. Could have been great if Complexity could have held on to the AWP, but it was good nonetheless. So we'll see what the CT side can do now. Kusta buying the AWP. Good nades on the CT side. Whitmer back on the AWP, obviously, as it was saved in the previous round. So we've got a 2-1-2 setup to start here for Liquid. Not going to have, I mean, often if the T's are moving for a fast play into mid, then one person's probably going to get wrecked most of the time. But Liquid have a read that Complexity aren't planning to do such a thing. Therefore, they will have just one person over there. Ooh, Kusta, unbeknownst to him, there are people in his vicinity. Will the shoulder peaks continue from Sanx? They will, but Kusta, that little shot through the smoke has scared him off, so he will not be able to capitalize.
Kusta's AWP is called Natural Causes, James.
I like it.
Death by Natural Causes.
I like it.
Reminds me of a story we once told about Producer Reese.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Although the best AWP name is still Ralen, King of the Internet is the name of his AWP, and that is amazing to me.
All right. Well, being king of LAN is more important in CSGO, I would wager.
Although one of my ops is called Final Atomic Buster, which is actually the best name. The king of the internet is a close second.
Well, we have the B split coming in from the Complexity side. Trent's the only guy there really to... Oh, actually, sorry, he's with a teammate. Oh, yeah, the name's pretty good. And he's there with Hiko, and this is going to be hard to break, I think, actually, with all the damage done by the nades as well. But Hiko goes down for free, pretty much. Adren gets one kill, but Elige comes in from heaven to take out Death as well. So it looks like it's a good defense overall from Liquid so far. Adren, oh, unable to hold on there. Flash goes down there to allow Elige to make another frag, as the bomb cannot be planted. Nice showing with the flank as well. This is pretty over right now, unless Surreal can do something pretty crazy. But he would have to get his total for his first half score to actually win this round. Fake in and out, they're going for the first frag. There it is, the transfer onto heaven. Not going to pan out as both players moved quickly to headshot. And that will be the round there for Liquid. So finally putting one on the board. Money has built quite decently for Complexity. Not significant, but it's decent. And so that will give them a couple buys before they have to eco. And Liquid, they need to string them together. If they get reset after this, they're going to be in for a lot of problems. But they have a good buy to hand.
If they lose this round, then it's game over. It's done. It's a wrap. We're going to three match.
That's your call.
That's my call. 6-1, it's game over then. I believe so. I don't really. Serial going to get taken down by Liege through the smoke. That's a good start. A very good start indeed, but it's still very early days here. And if Complexity can answer back, and indeed they will, if Kusa going down, then Liquid may have problems yet. Android X going to be dispatched of elsewhere. Once again, not making it to the Premier then. But smoke's coming into CT, but there is still a player on the site here. And Tanks may get himself a 1v1. I think it's Hiko on the site. Let's see if he can defend. Indeed, Hiko will go down, but Liege is back here with Silence M4 once again to try and keep Liquid in the round. Bomb's getting planted. It's a bad plant for the T's. There's only two of them left, so they might have problems with this defense. That said, all the Liquid players coming in from CT.
Yeah, great HE there from Whitmer as well. Onto Jireni. He's down to 30 points of health at this point. He'll try to flash his way in. He's got teammates to help him out as well as Whitmer and Def try to play this, but there's no support there from Whitmer. He's able to get one frag, but he gets traded easily as there's just too many players wrapping onto his position. Alicia's, is he defusing?
AWP rescue.
Okay, I was just going to say, I fought that initially, but he did wait quite a while there. But there you go. AWP is indeed rescued, and the round we won by Liquid. And in your opinion, on the hot seat, the Score Esports pre-game breakdown hot seat, you said that if they lost that round, they would be essentially losing the map, even though it's only 7 rounds played at that point. Yeah, you were daring to make that prediction, which I like, because usually you don't make any predictions. So I'm liking that you made a prediction at least. But they didn't lose that round, so you're, we'll not see if you're going to be correct or not.
Yeah, they're still in a match, Dan, because they won the round. So, Complexity, 3-round lead. It was 4, Dan, but then Liquid won a round, so now it's 3. That's how it works. But Liquid, they've changed the setup towards mid again, and Whitmer just going for the snaps here. Hiko getting shut down very quickly indeed. Whitmer's reacting really quickly at the moment, actually. I like it, and Kusta will be doing the same elsewhere, down to a 4v4.
So, it is time. It is soon becoming time, at least, for Complexity to start actually going onto a bomb site. There's the early round is sort of passed at this point, and now it is time to get onto the bomb site, and they are collecting themselves towards A. But that is where all of Liquid are, apart from one player which they've left on B just in case. So it'll be a 3v3, but they'll go in for the flash play to confirm what's going on, and indeed they'll lose two players. So that leaves Nitro alone, and that's a big problem there for Liquid. But if Complexity are too slow, they are going to be buying time for Kusta to come in to help Nitro. The Nitro, big job to do. Unfortunately, he won't find the weak player as he did back away. He was forced away by nades. Instead, he'll go for the wrap. What? Both players going down, Nitro and Kusta, finding themselves angles there. Angles for days. And that's Def now who has to plant. He's got 20 seconds to do that. Oh no! Kusta roasts Def. Oh dear, Def. It's happened to me before as well. I feel your pain. I feel your pain. But there you go. It's the 3-5 Liquid stringing yet another round together. And the reality is that Complexity did not get the bomb down there. So not even a possibility for a plant, which they would perhaps have been thinking of a force buy had they got the plant, due to the fact that they would have been able to buy something, and the nades and so on are really low for, or rather, sorry, the money is really low for Liquid, and they've invested in double AWP, so obviously one of the AWPs was saved, so it's an additional AWP that's been purchased in this round for Liquid, I believe, unless one was picked up, which I'm not sure that it was. Either way, the looks like a run boost peak coming in here. This is to bait out the first shot of the AWPer. And it's very effective in doing so. Also, it closes the distance between the pistol player and the AWPer. Oh no, they failed it. That's unfortunate. And oh, the spray down. So much damage here, but where are the frags? Two frags finally coming in for Hiko. He's going to double his score there. So we've got Adren in with the first defense, but Liege fast in the back with the MP9. There are the frags. There is the money. There is the round for Liquid as they go 4-5. And Complexity will have their buy.
Well, 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 the gap is being reduced yet more. So we'll see where Adren takes the second AWP on the CT side. No AWPs for Complexity. I do wonder if they will go for a fast round. They've got no smokes, actually. Well, they've got one smoke, excuse me, the T side. so one might expect a faster play, and indeed we've got a fast boost coming in. Kusa appears to be on fire, Dan. And, oh, Sanks gets absolutely wrecked, slamming Surreal as well. Whitmer will finally answer back. But great shots from both AWPers here. This is an entertaining map so far. Bomb rotating. We've got a fast push through Squeaky as well from Nitro. Could even see the bomb if they're not careful. Or moving over towards B now. Again, no smokes here for the complexity side. Will make things a little bit more difficult. Bomb coming in. And now Adren's answering with the AWP, leaving Whitmer alone. And that flank continues from Nitro. So Whitmer is in quite the pickle at the moment. He's going to cheat Plowman's, Dan. He is getting sandwiched by these CTs.
Wow. Yeah, just Whitmer left. He's not got the AWP, so no fear. But there are very low players here for Liquid. Whitmer goes in there for the first peek, and there it is. Producer Reese. Kusta is the X factor of that round. And here is the highlight. Oh, yes.
Nice. Very nice, Dan.
Producer Reese, he's the X factor. Yes. Yes, give me that overlay. Yes. Producer Reese, you get a bell. Good sir.
You get a bell.
That's team play, that is, James. Watch and learn.
Mano
and
Mano.
Me and Producer Reese.
Standing shoulder to shoulder, Dan.
He's in another room, James. So I wouldn't go that far.
Figuratively speaking.
All right, okay.
Well, we have the tease on in a half fight. There we go. Got it out in the end, Dan. Ooh, we've got trades, we've got flames, we've got bullets, we've got guns, we've got sniper rifles, Tech-9s and P250s. And we have a bomb being planted. The bomb is now planted. We've got Death on 8 HP. We've got a Molotov onto Adren. We've got HE flying through. Death is now dead. No Molotov required, although there is one on the site for the time being. And there is one more to be found on Adren. Can't thank you anymore for his team. He can't, Dan. There are bodies strewn all over the place.
All that fire really makes me think about barbecues, and I haven't had a barbecue this year yet, in any sense. Who wants to invite me to their barbecue? Is it you, James? You do not look like a guy who has barbecues.
I had a barbecue once, Dan, and we broke into a building site, and we got some bricks and like some corrugated iron thing or whatever it was, I don't even know. And we had the worst barbecue of all time.
I don't want to break any laws to have a crap barbecue, James.
Undercooked sausages, Dan.
So you even had a trip to the hospital as well. Great.
It was the worst barbecue you will ever see.
Well, definitely not having a barbecue if you ever invite me to a barbecue. So we've got now double up still rolling in on Liquid. They're looking to find much more comfort in the rounds here. Ooh, nice shot there from Adren. Although he will get traded upon, which is not good. Standing the flames though, Hiko will be able to take down Whitmer. Yes. Oh no! Oh, Hiko absolutely destroying his opposition there. Oh, after that first frag, it was too good to be true. They're all lining up for him, standing in flames, standing in front of each other. Hiko having a real star moment there. The three-star play, James. I'm going to give him 3 stars for that one. As opposed to the no stars.
Three
he was
stars
previously after. On when he team killed his teammate, and instead of adding to the round was a liability instead. But now he has created a resurgence. Redemption has been found.
This is quite the comeback, Dan.
Salvation is at hand.
Quite the comeback indeed. Two AWPs on the side. They've got two players around the A bomb sites at the moment. Kusta in a bit of an unlikely angle, taking one, taking two. Can he find a third? Elise stealing some kills away, but he's still alive on the site. Only one player lost, and they should have no trouble picking up the second AWP. Excuse me, two players lost. I mean, what was the score at the beginning? 4-0, and now it's 8-5.
It was 5-0.
It was, okay, so it was 0-5, and now it's 8-5 in favour of Liquid. That is a pretty good comeback. That means that Complexity are on the maximum loss bonus, but that's all well and good. But if they still continue to lose rounds, then they can have all the money. Well, they can have all the loss bonus they like, Dan. They still need to accrue rounds at the end of the day when all is said and done.
It's always going to be at the end of the day today. It's about the score. And score esports. In esports, the score. And right now the score is superior for Liquid, James. They have more rounds than their opponent.
They also have more games than their opponent. And it might be games of the match. They make it 16 on this map. Hiko's doing well to try and get them there. Two plays left here for Complexity. They do have the bomb, but they don't have much else going on. Liquid look to commit all their players over towards the B bomb site, but again, it's the T's who have control of the bomb, and they're not trapped. Therefore, Kustel will have to remain over towards that car position. Considering all the wars we've seen on Cashdown, that car's still in pretty good nick for the time being. At least trying to go for a bit of a flick there, but the spray down will be what is required, what is found, what is done, what is executed, Dan.
So do you know what country this map is set in?
This map is set in the country of Chernobyl, Dan.
It's Ukraine, yes. Yes. Chernobyl is not obviously a country.
I was waiting for you to say that.
But yes. It's in Ukraine. The Ukraine. Didn't they win Eurovision or something? I don't pay attention to that, but...
I believe so.
They did indeed. Wait, was that about Australia? Producer Reece says Australia should have had it. Sounds disappointed, James.
He's a big...
But may I remind you all that Australia is not in Europe, and it's called Eurovision, so get wrecked, Australia. Anyway, it's one round left in this first half, and Kista's just styling, getting the parkour on there, the jumps. No assistance required. And this buy is really suboptimal here for complexity. Tech9 on Surreal and Galil on Android X, and there's a lack of nades as well. So you need to really commit here when they use these resources. They need to get something out of them when they throw the utility, because after that, there's no more utility. So there is the what looks to be a mid-take setup. Grin's going to run past the smoke here to try to circumvent that. And he realizes that there's going to be Perz pushing here. Great first shot there from Adren, able to drop Sanks and maintain Liquid's control of mid, denying it. So utility expended, players expended in that mid-take, and they don't get mid, James.
Yep, and that is a pretty brutal smoke over towards the squeaky door. They indeed have mid down, and the bomb is kind of wearily moving over towards the bomb side, but they get a pick towards A, which makes things really awkward. They've got Death over towards Squeaky. So what does the bomb do now? The bomb's on his own. Android X can't take too many risks, because if he loses the bomb, they may lose the round. Death has been taken down towards A. There goes Whitmer as well. Now Sphere has no idea what's going on. Getting shot through the shutter. Down he goes. So it all falls apart for Complexity, leaving Android with 20 HP and a 1 versus 3. And now it's 0 versus 3, which Liquid will take. 10 rounds in a row, Dan.
Yeah.
0-5 down to 10-5.
No, yeah. Rounds that looked really dominant, to be honest. So it's hard to say what's going to happen in the second half at this rate. Like, there's been some moments of greatness from the Complexity side, but generally Liquid, yesterday we were expecting this kind of play from Liquid, basically, where you see a bit more discipline, a bit more structure, where you see the individual skill really come into play. And that's what's happening more today than it did yesterday. And that's obviously very important. I think obviously to some extent you have to credit the Team Caliber yesterday for showing good individual play and striking at a moment when Liquid are off balance in that sense. But now they are definitely looking a bit better, and once they get rolling and they get confident, you can really see that they're basically expressing through their gameplay, we feel like we are a better team and better players than our opposition. And that's really shining through, and in many senses, everyone will agree on that at the moment. So Liquid, with that confidence, can they win the second pistol round? They lost the first one. Now they're going for a B rush.
Well, Surreal decides to stand there with his knife out for some reason. And unfortunately, Dan, that's not going to net him any frags. Although, shooting through the smoke, he will find at least one. The bomb's down, and Liquid seems to be getting into formation now as the bomb gets planted for the Checkers area. But how can they hold? What will their post-plant situation be like? We still have Death over towards the car on A for some reason. He's only just rotating now. I have no idea why. But here we go. Adren and Co trying to hold things down here. Still getting tagged. Still getting finished off. Adren is putting in work here. Almost gets a third frag, but Nitro will be the man to do it. Nitro and Kusa left versus Android now as Death gets taken down. And he will be executed as well. I have no idea why Death was standing over towards car. Maybe he thought he saw somebody over towards A, but there was nobody anywhere near him.
Do you know, this reminded me of a little bit? Like with standing with a knife out there at Heaven and also Liege. Also had a moment where he's like running to the side, but then stops with a knife out or something weird, and it's not doing anything. It reminds me of when you're playing fighting games, right? And there's like a desync. Do you know? Do you remember those? Like, if you're playing on GGPO or something, and there's like a desync, you just see somebody pressing loads of buttons, but in reality, it just looks like a bot is playing them because not all the inputs are going through, and so sometimes they stop randomly and so on. It's quite humorous, but obviously quite frustrating because it's a desync. But anyway, it is going to be the 11-5, and just the anti-eco going into mid here for the Team Liquid side, or the anti-force buy, as Complexity have invested completely into this one. And off of the mid control that they have and the frags in which they have accrued in the course of this mid take, they can now decide to go for that B split. And it's looking pretty good here, especially with Allege on the long range frag there into the connector area. So it's just going to be the push onto Android. He's going to get crushed here. He's just got a Deagle. It's going to be so hard to deal with. He's got no helmet as well. He's against the MAC-10, MP7, AK-47, and Galil. No frags there for him, and the bomb will be planted. The round will be won unless Sanx can do something completely out of his mind. But I don't think that's likely. Interesting smoke.
Well, he's definitely running away to try and bait out some people, but Allege will be smarter than that, jumping around the corner to avoid the one shot, and he will punish. Dan, he will punish. He will be the bringer of punishment.
He is the disciplinary committee, James. He himself is the entire committee of discipline, and he will apply discipline with punishment.
He's the world police, Dan.
Team America.
Yeah, indeed.
World police, let's go. America. All right, so here we are. Got another mid take coming in from Nitro, fast in there with the AK-47. And it's a much worse situation here for Complexity. Having force in the previous round, they are now in a spot where they have nothing. They have to save fully, otherwise they'll have absolutely no money. Nice Molotov there for the great position, I have to say. It's a very nice Molotov, the way that it bounces. I enjoy the arc, the trajectory, geometry is not the right word, is it? No. What is the word? For the angles, I can't remember. Anyway, it's like a pretty clean round here so far here for Liquid. Only losing one player so far. Cleaning up the bomb site, just one left to deal with. And, not much to say here for Complexity. Other than goodbye. We have a tactical, though, it would appear.
Tactical
there are tactics.
A tactical espionage shooter?
No.
Isn't that one of the strap lines of this game? The number one tactical something or other.
I don't think it's espionage. Don't think there's any espionage. That would be
the Metal Gear Solid strap, actually.
Yeah.
I was thinking of tactical espionage something or other. I'm like three Metal Gear Solid games behind at the moment. How's that working out for you?
It's good. Having fun. Need to buy. Well, this is not mine. I just found it.
Found it
in the gallery. Our graphic designer was using it previously. Now I've taken it, James, for myself. If I see something I want, James, I take it. Like these things. Case in point. I don't think I broke any laws. Is it stealing? Don't know.
Well, 13-5 is the current score here. Liquid leading Complexity, and really they're taking a tactical pause. But I just don't know that there's much they can do. All things considered.
What are the tactics they need, James? What tactics do they need?
They need people in America rather than Europe, Dan. That's what they need.
Do they need... Okay.
They need people who are not playing with 130 ping, unfortunately. They need visas, Dan. They need visas.
Visas aren't easy to get, James.
No, Dan, they're not. I was in the US Embassy only today, Dan.
What were you doing in the US Embassy?
I was sitting in a chair, Dan, for 4 hours.
Why?
Because I was waiting for an interview. Which took less than 1 minute, Dan.
I've been there as well, James. It's not fun. Fun times. Led to believe something's worth it. And, well, I don't know. Anyway, we're back into the match. So don't have to delve into painful memories, which is good. I was feeling quite reluctant once I started. Either way, it's the 13-5. Liquid in a very good position. The tactical Complexity. Will it amount to anything at all? It's time to find out. Liquid also going to have the benefit of that timeout as well as their opponents. So let's see what they decide to run to try to screw over their opposition and perhaps their plans for this round. Nitro playing, kind of doing the well, I was going to say doing more than a get right there, actually, because he's actually going to go straight into the B-bomb site. It's not harassment, it's not threatening, it's not pressure, it's straight up just take the bomb site. So Liquid have the B-bomb site already, and this is awful because it's a pure reaction here from Complexity, and they've been caught. They've been caught, James, with the step behind the Liquid side. The round's already over.
Is the end nigh, Dan?
It would appear so. Liquid playing great.
Splinters on the chin. On the chin.
Yeah, Liquid are playing a great game so far, and they've got a great bank as well now. So they have a lot to work with. And Complexity, they seem to be in the seems to be a bit of a death rattle at this point. Just it's I mean, what do you say? Their position sucks, James. They've got pistols. They're going to go for a save. They're going to play for overtime, so they can have a better buy in the next round. Instead of trying to force up this round and try to have two crappy chances to and just get rounds, they're going to try to go for one decent chance. And I actually like the two crappy chances more because you just need rounds. You need an anomaly. You need that 10% basically to work out for you.
Yeah, I can respect that.
Yeah, that's kind of how I feel about it. But because it's going to be so hard if they win the next round, they have to win. They think there's no room for error. At that point, there's no room for error. And Liquid have been showing themselves to be pretty good individually so far as well as team-wise. Much better showing from them than yesterday.
We need to see, though, if Liquid will be able to identify the stack, Dan. We've seen problems from teams in Europe of identifying stacks on cash, where they've run into the stack, Dan, and then they've been launched into the birds. So we'll see if Liquid can avoid that from happening. We're seeing lots of Molotovs flying into the mid area at present. Lurking starting to emerge towards B, where there is only one player, that is Surreal, holding a bit of a dirty angle with the Deagle. Unable to kill anyone. And again, the difficult times ahead for Complexity. But again, Liquid, I do wonder when you move into sites. Completely empty. New teams often put themselves in like the best post-plant situations, even before the bomb goes down, since it's empty, you can just go into it straight away. Do they position themselves optimally?
I'm not sure. But Alicia is basically playing Left 4 Dead right now, James. He's playing Left 4 Dead.
Boomer.
Yeah, it's basically like the Boomer just spat on him, and they're all running at him. So good times. The Left 4 Dead versus mode was actually very fun. It's actually pretty cool. I must say, I really enjoyed that. I completed almost all of it on expert realism, which is pretty tough, takes a long time. Anyway, we have the 15-5 here for Liquid. They are on match point at this point. Hiko's going to go down to the AWP of Whitmer. Whitmer, you know, once again showing that once he gets the AWP, he can be quite prolific with it. Also, Android will be on the AWP here, as we can see. Although Liquid are in a position now where they have the time to work with. They can kill another 30 seconds to try to secure some basic map control. But that said, Andor is going to get a pick there. So the B storage player is down. And at this point, the round time doesn't really matter as much. Liquid just have to take a massive gamble, massive risk. Multiple risks need to be taken by Liquid to get in here. Each engagement is going to be a big risk, because each engagement lost is a massive drop on the percentage chance that they'll win the round. So let's see if they're going to be able to do so. There is a player in the vent room who has been, or rather the vents, which has been pushed into the vent room in Surreal, which is a nice play from Liquid. And I'm not sure if they would have heard that. And it's good to see the Complexity of playing a 3-2 setup in this way. This is the best way to play this kind of situation, to be honest.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Wimmer's just had enough of English people and their blasted pings, Dan. He's had enough. It's good to see a short smoke.
That was amazing, James. He died because nothing. The CTs didn't do anything, James. He literally just shot him in the back. Nothing
it's
happened.
Like, shut up. I'm tired of your nonsense.
Oh my god.
Well, Adren, can he do any more damage to these CTs? Nice shoulder picking, avoids the shot from Android, who picks on his own. Surreal will be the one to trade, however. But yeah, I like the short smokes. Always happy to see short smokes. Definitely don't see them enough, in my opinion.
Apparently they're quite confusing, it would seem. Apparently they're incredibly confusing.
Yeah, apparently it causes people to turn on each other, Dan.
Yeah.
To simply turn on each other. Well, 9 rounds behind now are Complexity. The bike is out for Liquid once again. Holding angles looking for some aggression towards B. The aggression is towards mid, and Surreal will get taken down by a bit of spray. I mean, there are a multitude of sprays that the T's will put in that position. Def trying to even things out, though. We'll see if he's able to do so. Nobody's holding the normal angles. Adren's moved to a more passive one, so we'll see if Def chooses to overextend. I'm sure Adren will be checking the angles here, but who's going to win this duel? It is going to be Def, so he takes one back for his team. Whitmer going for a few wallbangs there, but Hiko not being taken down. And now it's advantage. Hiko trying to avoid getting orped through the wall there. And Whitmer's three, well, one of them, Whitmer's going to have to reload soon, so we'll see if Hiko tries to punish him for doing so. That said, well, indeed, Hiko will take Whitmer down, so do wonder if it was on the reload there. We were over towards the other site where the bomb is currently. Kus has managed to pick it up, and he's making a run for it. But Hiko's been taken down at the same time, so Kus goes straight back towards the B bomb site. Going to push his way through the smoke, is he? Got Android holding a flash at present. He is over towards CT. We'll see if Kusa can make it over. Nice bit of a shoulder peek coming in there. And he will have time to plant the bomb. So Kusa versus two to try and save it for his team.
Yeah, this is very doable here for Kusa. Now there's no nades on the T's. Oh, CT's, and he's going to be able to get traded in the end by Def. But it's a very important peek from him to try to get the early pick off. And Liquid will have to wait. They'll have to wait some more to close this match out of its team. It does feel inevitable at this point with such a strong showing from Liquid and the money that they have in the bank that they would be able to close this one. But we shall see. Perhaps Complexity are going to make the 8 rounds in a row happen. It's definitely a long shot, but everything is doable in the game of Counter-Strike. One of the reasons why it is a great game. But how will things be faring here for the Liquid side on this bye? I mean, it would be quite cool to see just a straight-up set piece from them. I mean, they've had a lot of defaults, they've had a lot of early picking situations. It would be nice to see, if an explosive play wouldn't just catch off guard their opposition with a change of pace. You know, likewise, a slow set piece as well, a slow default into the set piece. But actually, this is great. Adren's going to pick off the Surreal. Great for Team Liquid. Going to pick off Surreal towards B, applying pressure in that side of the map. As his team sets up a play in towards the A side. The bomb is down, will be picked up though as the entries come in. Alicia's good on that front. 5v3 situation in favor of Liquid. Sang's coming in though, and he's got one frag here. He can do more from this position, but he gets critical damage done onto Hiko, but he won't actually be able to finish off the frag. But it's Android there with the AWP who's able to do some damage. The bomb is now down precariously in the middle of nowhere on the bomb site. Needs to be collected. It will be by Hiko, and he'll get the plant as well, I think. He's being safe as he can here, actually, but going for the plant now, edging onto the plant. And that will be the cue for the CTs to move forwards. And you can see Hiko is just trying to bait them here. Adren finding a great position. Adren could close this round here for the team. He's going to find the side of Death. One more player there. Android, they know where he is. Surely this is going to be the round for Liquid here. Such a hard round to be played by Android versus three players. Going to switch for the rifle there. Bomb now down. And he switches away at the wrong timing. Adren with the trio of frags in this round to secure it. 16-7. And that's the fast, super fast 2-0 there from Team Liquid. And I think the caliber of team that we expect Liquid to be, they essentially show their difference right now from Liquid to Complexity.
Yeah, I think Liquid will always have the discipline to take a match like that where, I mean, it's just, I think against a team like Liquid, it's going to be just too insurmountable a task, as good as Whitmer is playing. When you have two players with 120, 130 ping, that is a huge disadvantage for Complexity. So hopefully they can sort out their visa issue sooner rather than later, because obviously, again, it's just huge problems there. So we'll have a look at the highlights and see the more interesting parts of this particular map. But again, I don't know that Complexity were ever winning this. I mean, the best of three as well. Like, if it was best of one, obviously, the chances would be better. But we already saw this with Winter Fox last year. when Pit and Devil Walk were.
Devil Walk. Sounds like the sickest type of walk you can buy.
Devil Walk.
I love walks, James. You can do stir fries.
Devil
you can,
Walk.
You can even you can just do anything with them.
Great, that's walk, great, Dan. Let's get back into this. Replay.
Okay.
Well, yeah, we saw it with Winter Fox last right, year, right. And it was just a complete disaster.
It so was.
Hopefully, Complexity can get through these troubled times because it just sucks when you have to do this.
Yeah, I know the Complexity team has made its way to the IMG, what is it called? The IMG
camp
training camp, yeah, which is there for athletes and so on. It'd be really cool to see that actually happen for the CS team as well. I think it can only be beneficial. To me, that stuff is amazing. So I would love to see that more be more prominent in esports because I think there's a lot of stuff there that they discuss which is very easily never talked about, such as anything to do with sports psychology is never addressed or talked about, and this game is incredibly psychological from a huge degree of aspects that relate to performance, from just the general mental outlook in how you interpret yourself as a player, as to the way that you approach practice or your teammates, or the very nature of improving or looking at yourself for the ability to analyze to then feed into improvement. There's so many aspects of the mental game. And that's the kind of stuff that they tend to talk about. They have lots of seminars there. So it's really cool when I saw that.
That was quite a random segue.
What? Was it really?
Yes.
We're talking about improvement of complexity.
Okay.
And they're called team there. Well, it'd be cool to see their CS team go there as well.
It'd be cool to see them in the country.
That's also true. Oh, yeah, that's also true.
That would be a good start.
That'd be a good start.
I think we are going to close, Dan, with the Corsair Rapid Fire Plays of the Week, Volume 2, North America. Whenever you're ready.
Well, first of all, remember, guys, csgoleague.com is where you can find all the information for the league. And, of course, if you miss any of the scores,